Alrighty, there we go. Sorry I was a little late, I had to deal with a bug problem. Getting a little bit of scrap paper, but there's some bugs over there, gonna have to deal with that later. So yesterday we made the beam rifle. Just gotta turn on my blindness. Finished the beam rifle for the Gundam Calibarn and the shield. And so now all that we need to do today is apply the panel lining to the shield, then we will be finished. You know, just go over everything and then apply a clear coat to ensure the longevity of the build. Do just want to quickly show off with the backpack. See that there's this base here. Take one of these shield parts. When it gets slotted in, lines up properly with that, and then you can close that up in order to have the backpack hold on to two of the shield parts, and it just looks really cool. And I just want to quickly show that off. That's the form I'm going to have it in when it's completed. I just wanted to show that off ahead of time. Now then, there's one of the parts done. I'll show it a bit better than that. Get some detail. Oh, doing an atrocious job here. All along the build. There's one part down. Yeah, I'll just go with the thicker line. Nah, stay with the thinner lines. They're not as visible. With this one, you just need to run that. Do actually need to grab a file because this one wasn't done too well. There we go, that one's filed much better now. Same over that side. just line that and that. This one doesn't have too much stuff to get panel lined, though nearly you forget this part. Essentially, we're just making it so that there's the black line here and a little bit here. Just in the crevices. Make it a little bit more filled out and finished. Go. That's three parts panel lined. On to the fourth. Well, these parts have a lot more work to be done. Just making these small parts get that bit more detail in them. There we go. A bit more to do on this one. That's what that part looks like now. This is what it initially looked like. See all the black lines on it, just add a lot more detail. Make it overall look a lot better. This one's got a lot of points to add detail to, as you can see. That's going to be a bit more painful to do. Well, it's not too bad actually, just an itch on my leg. We're back to it. Not the cleanest, but I don't have the stuff to go into certain little crevices. That looks pretty good. Quite the upgrade from how it looked earlier. Final part. Oh. That looks a lot better like that. Got all the black lines on there. A lot more detail to it. So that means there's just a couple things that I want to just like check over the Gundams. Just want to quickly go over all the parts and make sure everything's properly panel lined. I didn't miss any spaces before I go over it with the varnish. Once the varnish has been applied, we can put the Gundam together and be done with the build. There we go. Just put that aside. Couple of things I need to get taken apart. Pop all of these off while I'm at it. Alrighty then. With that, a couple more parts to be checked first. And the skirt's falling apart now. Lovely. Yep, everything's good around here. legs and feet seem to be all good. Oh, here's a part. Now all of the players are in position. So then, if I'm correct, all I need to do, take my paintbrush, take the clear varnish, and just put a coat like over the parts in order to make it all work. So let's move all of the uncoated parts over here. Move these out of the way, have all the coated parts on the left side of me. Just take the cap off. There we go. Oh, it's got quite a smell to it. It's a bit sticky too. Just found a part that hadn't been detailed. So I'll just there we go. Now we paint him there just to make sure that's all good. Put a bit of the ink on the brush, have to reapply a bit now. So there's one part done. Just coat this foot. There's two parts done. That makes three. Now for the other leg. I'm just grabbing parts at random and applying. I'm gonna have to like go grab a cloth afterwards and just like dry off the parts once this has all been applied. fingers are getting all dirty from all the ink and varnish. Is a worthwhile price to pay for how good this is going to be looking forever and ever now, hopefully. See, it's making parts like shiny all over now. Well, you can't see it too well, but you can see it's a proper coating over each part. And then I just dry away the excess with a cloth afterwards. And then that'll be everything nice and handled. I think the best part about making sure that like this doesn't change is that I can see how much I've improved just by looking at the quality of like the panel lining. To once I have more and like better equipment for panel lining and just better at it in general. Hey Risk, I've been going quite well. How's your day been? Oh, it's been reporting me to be at one viewer for a good while now, so I just thought you were being quiet. So no, it still set me at one viewer, so I have no clue. Anyway, I have applied the details to the sword parts, and I'm just going over everything with the Vaseline or the varnish now, just to immortalize the build and make sure that I can look back and see how I've improved. No, I said Vaseline. I'm not applying gasoline to my Gundams. It is inescapable. This is just a running bit now. Every time it comes on, I just have to say it is inescapable. Alrighty then, with that, I've applied the varnish to everything. Yeah, no, this does have a strong smell, it's quite sticky too. Look at how dirty my fingers are now. I see it better like this. All dirty now and whatnot, it's sticky. Ooh, now you can see it, rubbed it off. The layer of varnish that was on my fingers. Now I'm going to become immortalized. Mwahahaha. I found the secret to immortality. Varnish one's flesh. Yeah, so I'm going to run this under some water. Do some stuff after stream to just clean everything up in general. But for now, I'm just going to go quickly grab a cloth to dry everything. I will be back in a second. Okay, I got two pieces of kitchen roll, that's gonna have to do. Alrighty then, that's one part dried. Two parts dried. So I can't dry everything perfectly, but I can at least clean it a bit with this. Get rid of excess and then just let everything dry properly. And it'll look a lot better afterwards. Oh man, there's even stuff on the back to apply to. Anyway, yeah, Vaseline's still on there, so I haven't wiped it off completely. Just clearing excess. Probably should have waited and let it dry a bit more first. But most of them are dried off mostly and just need to get wiped with a cloth just to get rid of any excess and shine and whatnot. Everything's a lot shinier now, I will say that. Does look nice. Yeah, there's a lot here where I applied excess. I'm not really sure how to apply just the right amount, so I apply too much and then clean up the excess later. That's my style now. Very gentle with the head. Just to not break anything. Oh, applied way too much on this one. And the decal's still coming off nonetheless. Oh, I think some of the varnish got underneath the decal and it's like gotten rid of the stickiness now. Oh well. I don't think the varnish is safe to eat, so, like, I don't think it's safe to consume. It's probably not the best idea to eat it now. And with this high grade Gundam calibarn is completed. Just pop that open so it doesn't boil up with pressure while I do this. Yeah. Boop. Okay then, now to put everything together. There's like little bits of dirt and or residue like built up, clumped Vaseline and stuff. Wipe that away with my thumb easily enough. Does look a lot better with all the decals applied, or all the details applied. So let's get everything nice and in position. that. Now then, do actually need to move all the bit to the side. Move that there. Pull out the manual, because we're plugging. Once we have the calibarn together, we're plugging the shield into all of the parts. So now then, let's put together all the parts that we took apart. See, it's a little, well, you can't see it too well, there's little bits of dirt around the place. Not perfect, but a lot better than what I used to make. So now, take the waist, clip that into the back. We take the body, plug it into the waist. Flip up the sides of the skirt, take the legs and plug them in. Place the bits of the skirt on nicely. Take the arms and plug them in, making sure that they're going into the correct side. Oh, it looks good, all coming together. Finally, place the backpack onto the back. That slides in quite nicely, I must say. Plug the head onto the top. Take the two beam saber hilts and plug them into the calibarn's backpack. Now, I'm going to put the shield together just to show like what it looks like in its completed form with the details all added on. And then these go here. That and that. And then we have this part around like so. These pieces go in with these parts facing to. Oh, wait, no. This goes in first. These go over that. This goes down the bottom, attach it on there and there. This is what the shield looks like with all of the details applied. It looks a lot better from how it did at the start of the stream. And now it's time to finish the kit. Put that to the side since we no longer need it. Take the parts and, as I mentioned earlier, slot them in correctly and lock them into position in the backpack, giving the Ariel's backpack wings. Plug these parts upside down, so the little arrow parts usually face up and now on the bottom side. Let's go like that. This part attaches to, there's that space there in the center, space here, that plugs in. Looks like that. You can plug two pronged pieces onto that if you'd like. Ah, I see I've made a mistake. Take these out and I'll deal with them in a sec. On the front. Just with the arms moved out of the way. Plug those bits into the thighs. On the right wrist, where the shield could be plugged in. Where the shield can be plugged in. Plug on this part. Oh wait, that was already in the correct spacing. Is it up or down? It is down. With the decal on the downside, pull apart the long parts of the shield. And the way that it works is back of the skirt, fold it out, and the big gaps that are there have spaces so that that little like curved bit there can slot in and lock in. Oh, that looks good. This kit is coming together beautifully, I must say. Start a social media page with before and after. That would actually be a good idea. I may do that at some stage. There we go. There we go. And this is what the back looks like. It's got the two wings and then the two pieces down here. The final step. Alrighty then. This is where it gets a bit difficult as we're getting into the posing of this kit. Right hand plugs in. The part that plugs into the backpack gets clipped in like that. And now it's properly like solid held. But now it's a bit tough to move as well because there's two arms holding already. There we go. Attach. Oh. Don't think I'm going to be able to get the left arm all the way over. Let's just quickly see. Yeah, it is meant to be possible. I need to move around the part that connects into the backpack first, though. So, take the right arm off. It can actually support itself with just the bit that plugs into the backpack. Like this. This should be able to attach on. A little bit more forward so it all works. There we go. Bring the handle back, bring the arm down over. Left arm is over as much as it can be right now. Quickly put it down. Cannot support itself on its legs. Let's see if there's anything here about it. the shield has a name. The shield is called Escutheon. Yeah, I have no idea how to pronounce that or what that means. Okay. So I'm thinking. So this needs to be like this, not the other way around. So as you can see, like, there's that gap. It's meant to be able to go, like, go on. Doesn't really seem to want to, though. Oh. Oh, there we go. Got it on there. Nearly dislocated the shoulder to pull it off, but now we open that up. Move the waist around, make sure everything in the correct position. The rule of the S-shaped body, making sure everything's plugged in correctly. So this all leans back a bit, legs come forwards a bit before bending a tad at the knees, with one leg further forward, one leg a little back, bent, foot up, forward, foot down a little, knee bent a bit more, leg forward a bit more. Everything's in the correct position. Bring the gun in closer to the body so the left hand can get on better. That's the best we're getting. Yeah, that's the best we're getting. Make sure nothing's wobbly and whatnot. There we go. Plugged into everything. Heads on as it should be. Now we get the stand that we made all the way back in part one. Get it in the correct spot. Plug it into the bottom of the calibarn. Keep going to call it the aerial. Boom. I love this so much. This looks amazing. It was so fun to build, well, some parts weren't, but this finished product of putting everything together, my favorite part of building the Gundam kits, when just everything comes together and looks amazing. So satisfying. Got that big rifle. It's got all that detail on the back as well. The left hand doesn't really reach over. I'm not sure how I was meant to do that any better, but it's meant to go all the way in here. I can't see too well, but it's meant to go all the way in there. I couldn't get it to do that. kit is completed. So with that, today's stream is finished. And that means that the Gundam is too. Gonna take a little break, so I probably won't be streaming tomorrow, but I do have like a real grade to make. So not taking a hiatus due to nothing to do, but I just love this so much. It looks so good. Yeah, so I'll see you in a couple days when I start building the real grade Freedom Gundam. See ya.